Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Dutch and this is Make Gears Great Again. In this video, I'll explain to you what game types are good to play in if you're looking to improve certain aspects of your individual skills and or teamwork. So let's get into it. The game modes we'll talk about are mostly respawn-based game types. And why? Because the game modes without respawns are largely based on situations, strategies, predetermined positions, and an initial rush at the start of the game. I want you to enjoy and experience rounds where you consistently play at the pace you have to. So those of you that are interested in being an aggressive, hairy-chested motherfucker, or if you want the uncensored version, the rushes and slayers, you're up first. King of the Hill, Annex, Blitz, Guardian, Capture the Leader and or Submission are the game times you want to practice the most in, especially by yourself. This is because these modes can have several spawn locations that force you to stay on your toes and keep moving. Movement is key in these game modes, especially as an aggressive role. You'll be going in between points of the map while you're intercepting enemies and practicing your goals that you set before the match. For those of you that play without a microphone, try to at least spot the first player, while moving of course, you see coming from a new direction that your teammates aren't looking at yet. This will give the slightest indication for them to start paying attention. Other than those two things, focus on clearing other potential power weapon spawns and becoming more comfortable sprinting around the map for many minutes at a time. If you happen to join a game mid-game and you're losing, start becoming a nuisance for the other team by simply moving behind them or in between them. Be a distraction so that your teammates can either kill them or focus their attention on the objective. Next up are the quote-unquote support players. And by support players, I also mean the snipers, power weapon players, team leaders, trappers, etc. Your game modes will be TDM, Guardian, and Blitz, or the equivalent thereof. So why these game modes? Because in most of these game modes, the main battle will be centered around the middle of the map, usually where the power weapons will be located. Most maps on Gears of War are completely symmetrical, but they still offer enough variety on both sides, visual-wise, to give you an advantage or disadvantage with certain angles. It's very important, as any of these roles I mentioned, to learn the spots and angles on the map that are a perfect lockdown positions. And what are their weaknesses? In case the other team uses those spots. Focus your attention on reacting to spawn swaps and predicting spawn timers of enemies and weapons. Do not confuse this playstyle or this attention to detail with spawn camping. You will need to learn what it feels like to be under constant pressure of the other team, so don't stay back the entire game. Try to provide some support in close quarters as well, using the same weapons you would from afar. You'll find out with each death how much practice you need on certain parts of your gameplay. And the last playstyle, the spawn campers. Your game mode is the menu, because why the f*** would you even play if you're not letting anyone else play? Play the f***ing game. Seriously. No, for real though. All of this is just advice from someone with over 20k hours over all of the games in 10 years. You can practice your playstyles in any game mode, but I've noticed in my own experience and those I've physically taught that these game modes work the best to train your rotation patterns. And that's just a fancy word for changing up your gameplay. That's it for this video. If you have any questions or need advice, leave a comment below. And as always, thank you for watching. Until next time.